Now let us see how amplitude modulation is actually done. You know, as in whatever we have done is a theoretical stuff, but practically how it is done, how it is produced. Okay, so write down next heading, production. Of amplitude modulated wave. Okay. Now, when you will be doing engineering, if you're planning to, then you'll be seeing, you know, lot of, you know, such things which I'm going to draw. You're going to see a block diagram here. So first let us draw, all of you. This is a plus. So you can superimpose two waves here. What we'll do, we will put here message signal MT, which is AM sine omega MT. Okay, and then you put here carrier wave. This is CT. Okay, this is AC sine omega CT. See, the way the amplitude modulation should be done will be in such a way that it should create three waves of frequency omega C minus omega M, omega C and omega C plus omega M. So if these three waves are present, no matter how you create AM wave, you know that it is fine. So it should have these three frequencies. Okay. So there can be multiple ways of creating these three frequencies. So this is what one of the ways is, okay, which we are going to discuss here. Then these two signals get added up. These two signals get added up and they become XT. So what is basically XT? XT is actually MT plus CT. Okay. And then whatever X you are getting, you are putting it in a square law device. This is called square law device. So whatever goes in here, whatever goes in there will come out as a quadratic. Okay, you will get YT, which is actually B times XT plus C times XT square. Fine. So you are not directly squaring XT. What you are doing? You are doing B times XT plus C times XT square. This is the square law device. Fine. And then you are putting under band pass filter. Write down band pass filter centered at omega C. So what does it mean actually, band pass filter? What it will do is it will actually pass those frequencies which are near about omega C. It will not allow frequencies which are far different from omega C frequency. Okay, it can only pass the frequency which are near about omega C. Okay, so once you have this band pass filter, you will get the amplitude modulated wave. Okay, so this is called AM wave. Fine. Now, what I want all of you to do is, this is the value of MT and this is the value of CT. Now follow this procedure and tell me what is the equation of AM wave you are getting on this side. All of you, please try this. What is the equation of AM wave you are getting at the end? So XT will be equal to MT, which is AM sine omega MT plus CT, which is AC sine omega CT. Okay, this is XT. Okay, now we have to follow the square law here. So this will be B times XT, which is B times AM sine omega MT plus AC sine omega CT plus C times this AM sine. So guys, this expression may look very big, okay, but then you have to try yourself. Until unless you try it yourself, you will never be able to reproduce it when it is asked in the exam. Okay, now what I want you is to open up all the brackets and tell me how many frequencies you get. You get two frequencies, four frequencies, five frequencies, or six frequencies. Quickly open up the brackets and tell me how many frequencies you have. Type in 2, 4, 5, or 6. How many frequencies you have in this particular wave? Are you guys trying? Then I will wait. So this will be BAM sine omega MT plus B times AC sine of omega CT, okay, plus C into AM square sine square omega MT, okay, plus C times AC square sine square omega CT, okay, then plus 2 times C times AM into AC sine of omega CT into sine of omega MT. Okay, now if you look at this sine square omega m, sine square omega m can be written as 1 minus cos of 2 omega m t by 2. Yes or no? So this you can write down like that, and this one you can write down like 1 minus cos 2 omega c by 2. Okay, and when you open up this, you will get two frequencies, omega C minus omega M, and you will get what? Omega C plus omega M. Okay, so this entire thing can be expanded as, now I have to make some space over here. So YT will come out to be, all of you please write down BAM this BAC minus C AC square by 2. See, I can understand it is little overwhelming, but then you know, it flows. There is a connection from one step to the other step. So you can easily write down, if you are sincerely doing it, you will get what I am writing here. Okay. So you should actually do it with me here. Otherwise, then, you know, before the exam, you have to anyway do it. And if you practice with me here, then you will have to make lot less effort later on. Otherwise, you have to do it from scratch when you, once you start doing it. Okay, this is what I'll get. Now let's count how many you know, frequencies we have. Omega M we have, omega C we have, 2 omega M, 2 omega C plus omega M, omega C minus omega M. So there are how many frequencies? We have 1, 2, 3, total 6 frequencies are there. Total 6 frequencies are there, and if I write down the frequencies, omega M, omega C, 2 omega M, all of you please write down this, omega C minus omega M and omega C plus omega M. Okay, now what I'm doing here, I am putting this, these 6 frequencies through a band pass filter which is centered at omega C. So since it is a band pass filter, it will only send the signal which are closer to omega C. So omega C will go, definitely omega C will cross the band. This band will not allow frequency which is far away from omega C. Okay, now tell me, are these two frequencies, these one and two, are these two frequencies, they are near omega C or they are very far from omega C? Far or near, please message. One and two, these two frequencies, they are far away from omega, very far, okay? Right, so they are far. So band pass filter will not allow these two frequencies. This is not allowed, this is not allowed. And even 2 times omega C is far, even this is far away. So if omega C is 10 kilohertz, 2 omega C will be 20 kilohertz. So even 2 times omega C is very far. Now tell me, omega C plus omega M and omega C minus omega M, 3 and 4, are they very far or near? they are near. Okay, because omega m, the message frequency is very less. So you are subtracting or adding a very less frequency with a very high frequency, which is omega c. So the band pass will only allow omega c minus m and omega c plus omega m. So that's how you generate these bands. Okay. So I hope you have understood this particular thing, and this is what transmitter does. Transmitter will take the message signal, do some sort of modulation, okay, amplify the power, and then send it through the transmitting antenna. So if I draw a block diagram of the transmitter, this is how transmitter will look like. This is the block diagram of the transmitter. It's a block diagram of transmitter. So you have message signal, this is message signal, you have carrier wave, okay, and this is amplitude modulation that is going on here inside the transmitter. Okay, so how much gap, sir, so how much gap is allowed? See, RN, it depends on what bandwidth you want to occupy. So you can depending on your message and omega c, the band will become fixed. So if you want to occupy higher bandwidth, then accordingly you will see what message signal you have to transmit. Okay, so there is no fixed answer to it, because the gap is different for different thing, but then it should not be very large. The gap should not be very large. It will have, the gap will have two times the frequency of the message, right? Because you have omega c minus omega m and omega c plus omega m. The difference in these two frequencies is two times omega m. So this is what the gap is. So two times the frequency of the message, this is what the gap will be. Okay, so coming back to this block diagram of the transmitter. So this is amplitude modulation, and here what you do, you amplify, you use that amplifier, transistor amplifier that we have learned. So you have power amplifier here, which amplifies the power of this modulated signal, and then this is transmitting antenna. Okay, so such is the complicated communication that happens inside our phone transmitting antenna. So transmitter inside our phone does all of this. Whatever you speak on your phone, that get transmitted. Okay, now this is with respect to transmitter. Now our focus is on the detection part of it. So at the receiver end, what happens, this is what is our next focus. So this is the last topic of this chapter. So this is after this the chapter gets over. Write down. Detection of AM wave. Fine. Now the way the amp, see, the thing is, transmitter modulates the signal and then it throws it through the channel. Okay. Now the modulated signal, although it contains the message, but modulated signal is not the message. Okay. So receiver will receive the modulated signal. Okay. And once the receiver receives the modulated signal, it has to extract the message from the modulated signal. Then only it can play at the receiver end. Like when you speak on your phone, the message, whatever you speak, it gets transmitted, and the person who receives it on his mobile phone, on his or her mobile phone, there will be a receiver who will be demodulating the signal which it is receiving. Okay, so the focus is on what happens at the receiver end now. Okay, so we are talking about the amplitude modulated wave. Okay, the way amplitude modulated wave is received. So we have here a block. What it will do, it will amplify the received signal. This is amplifier. Okay, and this time in the receiver, the antenna comes first. In the transmitter, the antenna comes the last, because you have to do all the processing and then throw it through the channel. Fine. So antenna comes the last in transmitter, but in receiver, it should first receive. So that is why the antenna coming first when we talk about the receiver. So this is the amplifier. The message, the modulated message goes to the amplifier, and then you have this block is called if stage. Okay, we'll not discuss too much about how this if stage is getting constructed or how the amplifier get constructed. Okay, what is the antenna, what is the construction of antenna, all that is a very involved topic. This you will learn in your engineering. The basic construction of antenna itself will take a couple of months to understand. This is detector. And then again, we have amplifier. Okay, this is amplifier. And here is the output. This is what you receive, or this is what you hear through your speaker. This is what you hear. Okay, so before hearing, the message gets amplified. What detector does, it detects the message after if stage. Okay, let's see all of it, how it happens. Okay, so you have, suppose, amplitude modulated wave, which comes like this. This is the amplitude modulated wave. So this amplitude modulated wave comes, okay, then what you do, you put it through a rectifier. There is a rectifier. What rectifier will do, it will convert this alternating signal into direct signal. So you are using a full wave rectifier here. So what you'll get is this. This one remains, the lower one is gone. Okay, then what we are doing here, this is envelope detector. Envelope detector will detect the variation of the amplitude and reject everything else. Okay, so at the end, only this will remain. Okay, and this is the shape of the message signal. Fine. So I hope you have understood this particular thing. The if stage is actually rectifier, and this envelope detector is this, okay? And before if and detect, before if and after detector, you have amplifier. Okay, so if you want to draw a block diagram on how it is done, you can do that also. So here we have rectifier, and then it goes to envelope detector. Before the output comes in. So in this block diagram, we haven't drawn the amplifier, but amplifier is required because the at times signals are very feeble. All right, so this is what the entire chapter is all about. I hope you have understood the entire thing. And in case you have any doubt, please message me right away. Anything with respect to this chapter, okay, you have any doubt, please message. Or if you don't have a doubt, then also please message that no doubts, so that I can proceed further. Okay, so I'll take that answer for everyone, no doubts.